In today's video, you will learn how you can take the photos for the 3D model which is needed for me to make your devices. Don't worry, it's completely free, super easy and takes less than 10 minutes. The photos will be used by me in a special software which has artificial intelligence. It's able to align the photos and create a three-dimensional model of them. This procedure is called photogrammetry. After I made the 3D model of you, I can decide what type of device is what you really need, and I will send you your options. If you like and agree to one of my options, then I will design the 3D model of your special device. Step 0. Find someone. You need someone who is going to take pictures of you, so ask your partner, a family member, or a friend to help you out. Step 1. Camera settings. Apps. So, your first step is to choose the device what you will use to take the pictures. If you have a high quality camera or a photographer friend, then you are lucky. But if you don't have anything else, just your phone, it's fine. For my 3D model, I use the mediocre phone with a mediocre camera. If you are going to use an iPhone or any Android phone, then you will need an app called Adobe Lightroom. This is a completely free app to use and it can be downloaded from iOS App Store and Android Play Store. The reason you need this app because it has much better auto adjustments than your regular camera app. On top of that, we can change these settings manually if we have to. If that wouldn't be enough, the pictures are going to be in DNG format, which can be modified later much more than a regular JPEG picture. So head over to the App Store or Play Store, search for Adobe Lightroom or open the link in the description. Click on Install. Once it's installed, open it. If you have an Adobe account, you can sign in with that. Or alternatively, you can quick sign in with Facebook, Google and Apple. If you don't have any of those, click on the Sign Up button and register with your email. Once you are in, you should see this. Now click on this little camera icon in the bottom right corner. Allow access for the app to use your camera. From left to right, SS means shutter speed, ISO means light sensitivity, WB means white balance, square icon stands for the focus, and reset, if you change something, it resets everything back to auto. As you can see, all of them are set to automatic. We are going to leave it as it is. If you try it, you can see that it produces much better pictures than your basic app. We will only adjust it if something isn't right. I will talk about this app in the next sections too. Optional setting to make a grid on the screen. Click on the three dots. Now click on the eye icon and turn on the grid. This can help to point the camera better. You should aim the center point at the upper app level. Step 2. The cardboard sheet. So, in order to make your 3D model as precise as possible, I need a reference measurement on the model. What I found to be the easiest and most precise is a 10 cm by 10 cm cardboard sheet taped on the stomach. To make this, you will need, first, cardboard sheet. Everyone has empty cardboard boxes at home. Be creative. It doesn't have to be made out of cardboard. It can be anything really, just make sure that it's thick enough to not bend. Measure out a 10 cm by 10 cm square as precisely as possible and cut it out. If the cardboard isn't stiff enough, you can cut out more pieces and glue them together. Second, tape. So you will need to tape this piece of cardboard to the lower part of your abs when the pictures are taken. It can be any tape really, two-sided ones are probably the best, but one-sided ones are just fine. Step 3. Set the environment. Believe it or not, half of the work is already done. We need to choose the right place and lighting for you. The best thing what you can do is to find a room inside where you have multiple lights. What you really want to avoid is shadows on your body, especially on your chest. If you only have rooms where the light is on the top, then make sure that you are right under that light with no shadows on your chest. If your light settings aren't optimal, don't worry. You can use the advanced settings to compensate for that. Another important thing is the background. So the background must be static, not moving at all. Moving makes the AI crazy and the result will be poor. So no moving humans, cars, pets, or television, or even a mirror which reflects differently all the time. Step 4. Taking the pictures. So, the environment is set. Now I need you to sit down. Use a chair which doesn't have a backrest and tape the cardboard on your lower abs. For the time the pictures are taken, you can't move. Breathe slowly, don't move your head, hands, feet. Just sit there, relaxed. If you move, then you have to restart the whole process. Make sure that your posture is good while the pictures are taken. Your back must be straight, but not forced. Imagine that someone is pulling you up by your head towards the ceiling. Secondly, bring your shoulder blades back. Don't overdo it, just reach a natural position. Now you need to hold this position without moving. Now I need to speak to your helper on how to take the pictures. First, I want you to imagine the person in a top view mode. Now imagine a circle around that person, which is around 1 meter away. Now imagine 4 points on the circle like this, and then the rest 8 points just like this. This way you will have 12 points around the person. You are going to stand on these points when you are taking the pictures. Now I want you to imagine the person in a side view mode. Now imagine that you are standing on one of the red points, what we talked about earlier. Taking a picture at every green dot at an angle what the white arrows show. You need to take at least 5 shots, but it can be more than that. Just to clarify, you need to focus on the upper body from the head or neck to the belt line. The sequence what you need to follow is this. Start at the top and going down from there. When you took the last picture, you take a step to the next point and then you go from the top to the bottom again. You need to repeat this until you fully circle the person. When you are done with that, the pictures add up and create a dome shape around the person. Now let's see this in 3D. This is the 3D model, what I will use to illustrate everything. This is the cardboard sheet, taped on the stomach at the level of the belly button. Shadows are only under the model and not on the body. Here is the side view. As you can see, the back is straight together with the neck and the shoulders are retracted. Back view. As you can see, the scapulas are retracted too. If you are going to use Adobe Lightroom, this is the time to open the app. Now, as we spoke about it, you should leave everything at default. I hope you remember this picture. We are going to start at this point. As we spoke about it, we start at the top at an almost vertical angle. This is what you should see in the camera. To adjust focus, you simply tap on the center with your finger. Normally it holds focus well, but at worst you need to adjust it before taking the top pictures. So you take a shot and this is the picture what you will get. Going down a little bit. And taking another shot. Going down further. And taking another shot. Fourth. And taking another shot. Finally, the last one. And the last shot on this point. Take a step to the next point. Take a step to the next point. And the cycle repeats until you arrive back to the starting point. Keep in mind that 60 is the minimum amount. You can have more pictures, and I highly recommend to have 100 pictures. In my case, 6 pictures were taken at 16 points, resulting in 96 pictures altogether. The more pictures you have, the more overlap there will be, so the end result will be better. Advanced settings. So as I've mentioned, you should keep every setting as it is, automatic. But you may don't have the best environment, you can make up for it with the professional settings. So, first thing which isn't really professional is the flashlight. Normally, you want to have enough light which isn't coming from your phone. But if you just don't have enough light, you can turn it on. Don't forget, if you use it, then you need to use it for every picture. Second thing is the exposure. Exposure is made out of three elements. First, shutter speed, second, ISO, and third, f-stop. You probably want to adjust it because the pictures aren't bright enough. The problem with this is that with higher exposure, you are sacrificing quality. You introduce more noise to the picture, it's not going to be that sharp anymore. Your best bet is to have more light source instead. You really want a low ISO number, like 100. That's the sharpest, but also that's the most dark one. So in order to make the picture brighter, you want to go down with the shutter speed. The problem with this is that the motion blur will be very high the lower the shutter speed gets, and you will need a tripod for that. The F number can be adjusted directly in Adobe Lightroom, but if you use a camera, the suggested value is between F8 to F11. Step 5. Sending the pictures. So first, you need to check the pictures. Open Adobe Lightroom and go to All Photos. You can check the pictures if they are not blurry, there are no shadows, your body is well lit, the background is static and you didn't move, not a little bit. If everything is right, you need to choose every picture. First, press on the first picture until it's highlighted. Now click on the three dots in the top right corner and hit Select All. Now click on the share icon, then click on Export As. Now click on the Preset button and choose Save Original. And finally hit the tick in the top right corner. This can take a few minutes. Once it's done, you need to open Photos and head over to the library. Adobe Lightroom created a new folder there with the name of Adobe Lightroom. You can find this folder in a File Explorer too. Click on the tick icon, it will highlight every picture. At this point, depending on whether you have a Gmail or iOS account or not, you can choose from first, create link with Google Photos or iCloud Photos, or second, upload to another cloud drive like Mega. Create link, Google Photos. Click on the share icon on the top. Now click on create link. Once it's done, an album is created and the link is automatically copied. You can paste this link into your browser and check the album. Create link, iCloud Photos. First, click on Select All and then click on the Share icon. Now just click on Copy iCloud link. You can paste this into your browser to check it. Upload to Mega. So, if you don't have a Google or Apple account, alternatively you can use other cloud drives, for example Dropbox, Microsoft OneDrive, etc. But I'm going to give you a tutorial for a completely free cloud drive which is called Mega. You can go to mega.nz in your browser and follow the steps there. But I'm going to go through the app what you can download from either Android Play Store or iOS App Store. So open up Play Store or App Store and search for Mega. Or open the link in the description. Click on Install. Now open it. You should see something like this. Now click on Create Account. You need to fill this out with your details. Tick the boxes and then click on Create Account. You will see this and it means that you need to open up your email and tap on the link to verify your account. Once you are done with that, you will need to log in with your details. We will choose the free one and then skip the two-factor authentication. Now we are in. Click on the folder icon in the bottom left corner. Click on the plus icon. From the menu, choose Create New Folder. Name it to something like Pectus Connectus _ and your name after that. It will put you in the folder. Now click on the plus icon. From the menu, choose Upload Files. In my phone, the Adobe Lightroom folder was in the Pictures folder, but it's maybe in the DCIM or Photos folder. Once you are in, click and hold on the first picture until it's highlighted. Click on the three dots in the top right corner and then click on Select All. Once everything is selected, click on the Select button in the top bar. Once the pictures are in the folder, go back to the main Files menu. Click on the three dots next to your folder. From the menu, tap on Get Link. Now all you need to do is to click on Copy Link. Sending the link. Now that you created a link for the album in one way or another, all you have to do is to send it to me to pactusconnectus@gmail.com. I will reply as soon as I can.